गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन।
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
गुड आफ्टरनून।
हैज एवरीवन जॉइंड और एनीवन इज लेफ्ट?
सो आई थिंक मोर स्टूडेंट्स विल जॉइन।
ओके सो लेट्स वेट more two minutes more. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, let's start. Can you see the screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, in circuit theory, there are two parts. Okay, the first one is network analysis, and the second one is network synthesis. Energy sir will cover the analysis part, and I will start the synthesis part. So, what is the difference between synthesis and analysis? In analysis, you have to given up. You will be given up network circuit, and you have to analyze the circuit. For example, suppose in a circuit there are lots of resistance, capacitances, dependent or independent sources. And in that case, suppose you have applied input, and you have to find out what will be the current, what will be the output. The input may be current, may be voltage, and the output can also be current or voltage. So in analysis, the circuit will be given and the input will be given. You have to find out what will be the output for different given conditions. And in case of synthesis, what you have to do? In case of synthesis, you will have a system. Probably you know from the signal and system class that a system is defined by a transfer function. Do you know what is transfer function?
No, ma'am.
Hello?
No, ma'am. No, ma'am.
So, in signal and system class, what you are studying? Only the signal part?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so very soon you will study what is a system and how a system can be defined. In very simple, I will say you, system means which will be defined or which will be characterized by a transfer function. Transfer function means if you give an input and if you multiply it with the transfer function, you will get output when all input and transfer function are in frequency domain. So in time domain, you will not be able to find out the output using the transfer function. Here, what you have to do? You will be given a system, that means a transfer function in frequency domain. in this here you can see the transfer function is fs. What does it mean? Fs means it is output in frequency domain divided by input in frequency domain. So if an input is given and the transfer function is known, then you can find out what will be the output. So output will be equal to transfer function into the input signal. Of course, all will be in the frequency domain or S domain. You can see here it is written in S. The variable is S. S means sigma plus j omega, where sigma is the real part of the frequency and omega is the imaginary part of the S. Okay. So, yes.
Your talking is very fast. I cannot catch every.
Okay, since you have not studied the system, so it may be difficult for you. So a system will be defined by a transfer function. Suppose it is fs, then what will be fs? Fs will be output of the system divided by input. Okay, suppose a transducer. In case of transducer, you will be given current at the input and you will get sound at the output. So sound divided by current in frequency domain will give you the transfer function of that particular transducer. Clear? Output divided by input in frequency domain, in S domain, will give you the transfer function. Is it clear? Output by input, but not in time domain, real time domain, which we are visualizing, is not transfer function. It will be always in frequency domain, S domain, small s domain. Okay. Since it is purely mathematical class, so I will request you that you please do these calculations by yourself. Okay. I will share, but if you don't write, then you will not be able to understand, because if you have not studied the signal system part till now, so it will be difficult if you don't solve by yourself. It is purely mathematical class. Okay. I will share my PPT after the class, but I will request you, everyone, please be ready with your pen and paper.
Ma'am, can you show the PPT in landscape mode, because the writing is very small.
Okay.
No problem. Now it is clear?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, you don't need to write all those properties, because I will share all the things. But what you have to write, you have to do mathematical steps, which I will come to later. Okay, for the timing, please listen carefully. So, in case of network analysis, to you, because transfer function means it is the characteristics of a
system. Ma'am, apnar voice ta break korlo.
Ekhono ki break korche?
Eibar asche. Eibar bolun.
Okay. So, in case of transfer function, in case of analysis, the circuit will be given and you have to find out different parameters. Okay, that's NRD sir will cover. But for my part, system characteristics, which will be in the frequency domain, such as fs, here it is written, one expression is given. So this type of expression will be given to you, and what you have to do, you have to find out what will be the circuit elements. That means what will be the value of the resistance, what will be the value of capacitance, will it be in series or in parallel. So all those things you have to find out from this synthesis part. So I'm not going to detail of the synthesis right now. Before that, we'll study first positive real function. So if a function is not positive real, then that will not give you a stable system.
Okay, so first thing what you have to study that whether the system that is given to you is stable or not. And to be sure that it is a stable system, you have to first examine whether that given function is positive real or not. Clear up to this?
Yes.
Okay. So let's proceed. So a general form of the characteristics function is given here. You can see it is a polynomial in the numerator as well as in the denominator. So for the numerator part, you can see the degree of the numerator is n, small n. So it is a n s to the power n plus a n minus 1 s to the power n minus 1 plus up to a 0, where the power of s is 0. And in the denominator, you can see the degree of the denominator is m, small m. So the polynomial will have a form like bm s to the power n plus bm minus 1 s to the power m minus 1 plus up to b0. Again, b0 means b0 s to the power 0. Okay, so if this is a general form of a system, that means this is the transfer function, then how will we examine that whether this function is positive, real, or yes or no? For that, there are certain conditions. First of all, what we have to notice that the degree, difference in degrees between the denominator and numerator will be always equal or more than or less than by 1. That means suppose n equal to 3, that means a3 s cube plus a2 s square plus a1 s plus a0 is the numerator. And suppose m equal to 4, then the denominator will be b4 s to the power 4 plus b3 s cube plus b2 s square plus b1 s plus b0. Okay, so here I have assumed that n equal to 3 and m equal to 4. So in this case, you can see the difference in degrees is 1 because m is 4, n is a 3, so m minus n is 1. Again, if n is 4 and m is also 4, then also it will be okay to check whether the function is positive real or not. But suppose n is 6 and m is 4, then what will be the difference? The difference will be 6 minus 4 equal to 2. And by just noticing the system, you can easily understand that the system is not positive real. The function is not positive real because the difference in numerator and denominator degree is 2, which is more than 1. So the degree difference can be equal. That means the degree difference can be 0 or maximum 1. So can you tell me if n equal to 2 and m equal to 4, is the function will be positive real?
Ma'am, anyone? N equals to 2 and m equals to 4.
Yes, yes.
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Okay. No. Because the difference between numerator and denominator degree is more than
1.
It?
1.
Okay. So this is the first point that you have to notice the difference in degrees between numerator and denominator. If it satisfies, that means if it is between 0 to 1, then we will go to the next step. That means we have to find out the poles. And we have to be sure that there is not more than one multiple poles on the j omega axis. What is j omega axis? I told you s. Small s means sigma plus j omega. Sigma plus j omega. Sigma means
ma'am, we can't hear you. Ma'am, apnar kotha ta majhkhane kete geche kono ekta shomoy.
শোনা যাচ্ছে?
হ্যাঁ ম্যাম, শুনে যাচ্ছে।
ওকে, সো সিগমা প্লাস জে ওমেগা। সিগমা মিন্স ইট ইজ এক্স অ্যাক্সিস এন্ড ওমেগা মিন্স ইট ইজ ওয়াই অ্যাক্সিস। ওকে, ইট উইল বি বেটার ইফ ইউ স্টাডি দ্য সিগন্যাল সিস্টেম ফার্স্ট, দেন ইট উইল বি ইজিলি ফর ইউ। ওকে, ইফ ইট ইজ নট, সো y-axis is the omega axis and x-axis is the sigma axis. We have to be sure that there is no multiple number of poles. That means the root of this FS will be one. Only single pole will be there on the j omega axis, and there should not have multiple number of poles. That means suppose j omega equal to 2 into 2j. Okay, omega means 2, so 2 into j, and if 2j has number of 2 roots or 3 roots, then the system will not be stable, or it will be not a positive real function. So we will allow only one single pole on the j omega axis, not multiple number of poles. Clear this point? We have to find out the roots.
Yes.
And we that whether there are multiple number j omega axis or not. If there is a single root on the j omega axis, then we will say that it may be positive real. But if there are multiple number of poles on the same j omega axis, then we will say that yes, it is not a positive real function. Okay. And third point is that there should not be any pole on the right half of the S plane. Right half means x-axis is sigma, and negative x-axis means minus sigma. So sigma positive means the system is diverging. You will study everything in signal and system class, but still I have to cover this one. So for a system to be stable, there should not be any poles, not a single pole on the right half of the S plane. That means on the positive sigma plane. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So first you have to study the difference between the degrees of the numerator and denominator. If it is greater than 1, then it will be not positive real, and if it is less than 1, then you can say that it is the it may be positive real function, depending on whether there are multiple number of poles on the j omega axis, there are right poles at the right half of the S plane. Okay, so all these conditions must be satisfied to get a positive real function. Now to find out the roots or to find out the poles, what you have to do, we have to study Hartree-Weil polynomial. What is the Hartree-Weil polynomial? Let's FS equal to PS by QS. As it was written, it was a ratio of two polynomials. Suppose the numerator polynomial is PS and the denominator one is QS. Okay, so it will be Hartree-Weil if PS and QS both are if QS is the Hartree-Weil polynomial. Okay, so what is QS? QS is the denominator of FS, and if QS is Hartree-Weil polynomial, then the system will be stable. So let's proceed. What are the conditions for a Hartree-Weil polynomial? For a function to be Hartree-Weil, what you have to first find out? You have to first find out that for all real values of S, the value of FS will be real. Okay, that means if you put S a real value in this expression, if you put a real S, then always you will get a real FS. Okay, then you can say that this is the function is the Hartree-Weil. So that is the first condition, that for all real values of S, the value of FS should be real. And as I told you earlier, the real part of root should be negative or zero. That means there should not be any pole on the right half plane. So the root should be always either zero or negative. That means either on the j omega axis, zero means real part, zero means sigma equal to zero. That means it is on the j omega axis, right? clear this point? Either zero means sigma equal to zero, x-axis equal to zero. So it will be, the roots will be on the j omega axis. And negative means sigma will be negative. That means on the left half of the s-plane. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And then after finding the roots, that all the roots are either zero or negative, that means the real part of the roots are zero or negative, then we will go to the next step. What is the next step? We'll note the coefficient, that means bn minus 1 to b0. Okay, and we'll see that all the coefficient, that means bn to b0, will be positive. Okay, so here, since QS is the denominator and QS will be a Hartree's polynomial, so we will study QS first. So here you can see BM to B0, all these coefficients should be positive, and at the same time, we have to be careful that BM and BM minus 1. Okay, that means the highest two coefficients will not be 0 simultaneously. That means if bm minus 1 is 0, then bm will not be equal to 0. And if bm is equal to 0, then bm minus 1 is not equal to 0. So first, you have to be sure that for all real values of s, fs is real. Then you have to find out the roots. That means all the roots, all the real part of roots are either 0 or negative. Then you have to be sure that all the coefficients of the denominator are positive. And the highest two coefficients, that means bn and bn minus 1, will not be 0 simultaneously. Anyone can be 0, but both of them can't be 0 simultaneously. And one more thing, that in case of QS, and obviously for PS, I'm not telling PS right now, as I told you that bn and bn minus 1 can't be 0 simultaneously, but it can be 0 if all even terms or all odd terms are absent. That means suppose the system is 3a square plus 2. Here you can see 3a square, that means the degree is 2, highest degree is 2, and plus 2 means it is 2 into s to the power 0, right? So it is even function. The power of s is, first one is 2 and second one is 0. So it is even function. So there may, you can say that here s term is absent. That means s to the power 1 is absent. But that is not actually harmful, because the entire function is an even function. Even if suppose the function a function fs is given as 4s cube plus 1 plus 2s. In this case also, you can see the power of s is 3 and 1. 2 and 0 are absent. So it is also, it may be also a positive real function, because it is only odd function. Clear? In case of any doubt, you can ask me.
Okay.
Okay, so next, what you have to do after finding all these things, you have to take continued fraction. I will come to this continued fraction term. Continued fraction expansion means there is a ratio of PS and QS. So first, what you have to do, you have to divide PS by QS. Then you have to take the inversion, and then again you have to divide. So division and inversion, again division and inversion, this process is called continued fraction expansion method. Okay, so two Hartree's polynomial will always have this expansion coefficient positive. Okay, just test this one. Suppose PS is the polynomial, okay, given polynomial, which we have to find out whether it is Hartree's or not. For that, what we will do first, we will divide, separate the even terms and odd terms. Suppose the even terms is RS and the odd part is TS. Okay, so PS will be equal to RS plus TS. It is the sum of even terms and odd terms. Now what you have to do? You have to do the continued fraction expansion method. Here you can see RS by TS. Okay, so first you will divide RS by TS and you will get a coefficient A1S. Then you can see after division, the numerator will be smaller than the denominator, right? Because residue will be smaller than the TS term. So after this division, you have to do inversion. That means 1 divided by the residue. Then what will happen? The numerator will be greater than the denominator and you will be able to divide. So after second division, you will get the result as A2S. Again, the numerator becomes smaller than the denominator and you have to take the inversion. That means again 1 by that term and you will get A3S because now the denominator is smaller than the numerator. So in this way, it will continue till the there is no residue. For example, okay, in this case A1 can be zero. Okay, in this case for the first one, A1 can be zero because if RS has less degree than TS, then you can't divide RS by TS. So in that case, you have to take inversion at the beginning, then you can divide. So depending on the degree, if RS numerator has higher degree than denominator, then there will be division first. And if RS has smaller degree than the denominator, then you will have to take inversion first. So depending on the degree, you will get A1 non-zero or zero. So let's do an example and I will request you that you do by yourself this one. Okay, otherwise you will not be able to understand. So here an example is given. PS is S to the power 4. S to the power 4 plus 3S cube plus 4S square plus 5S plus 2. So first, what will be our job? Our job will be to separate out the even terms and odd terms. Even term means RS. What are the even terms? It is S to the power 4, 4S square and 2. So RS will be equal to S to the power 4 plus 4S square plus 2S to the power 0. Similarly, the odd terms will be TS equal to 3S cube plus 5S. That means S to the power 3 and S to the power 1. Now what we will do? We will divide the even terms, even term RS by odd term TS. Here you can see that the even term has S to the power 4, that means degree is 4, and for odd term the degree is 3. So you can easily divide. So first make the division. Koro tumra. Just division. Amra jebhabe choto bela division korechilam, S to the power 4 plus 4 square plus 2 within bracket. And you have to divide this term by 3S cube plus 5S. Korcho, everybody is doing or not?
Yes, ma'am, you are doing.
Okay. Since the numerator has higher degree than denominator, so here you can divide at first. You don't need to take the inversion. Okay. Got the term 1 by 3s, 1 third s?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so what is the residue then?
7 by 3 s square plus 2.
Okay, so now what is the remaining term? 1 by 3s plus? Plus what? What is the residue? Hello. 1/3s plus. What is the term after division? What did you get?
7/3 a² + 2.
So at the numerator there will be 7/2 a² + 2, and at the denominator it will remain same. That means 3s³ + 5s. Right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so now you can see that the next you just leave 1/3s because you have got thing with this 1/3s, because a1, the coefficient, first coefficient a1 is, if you compare with this one, the first coefficient a1 is now 1/3, right? So now consider the next one. That means the residual part divided by the 3s³ + 5s. So here you can see that in the numerator you will have a degree of 2, right? And in the denominator you have a degree of 3. So what you have to do, you can't take any division. What you have to do, you have to take the inversion. That means 1/3s³ + 5s divided by that residue. Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
So now they again do the division part, because you have taken the inversion. So next part is division. Now you have to divide 3s³ + 5s by that residual part. 7/2 a² what you have told you, I can't remember clearly. Okay, so after that division you will get the result as 9/7s. Techo?
Yes, ma'am.
So 9/7s is your a2. If you compare with this first expression, general expression, A2S, you have got A2 as 9/7. And what is the residue again?
51/7S.
Then?
One minute.
Yes. Problem hocche
ma'am, it's 51/7s.
Only 51/7s. Okay, then in the denominator you will have, it is the numerator, 50/7s. Sorry,
7s² / 3 + 3.
Okay, so now what you have to do, again you can see that the denominator has higher degree than the numerator, so you can't take the division. Again do inversion. That means 1/ next term korecho, 1/ next inversion and division. Did you get 49/51s?
Yes.
Okay, so again write down the residue and again take that inversion, and you will finally get that a3 is 49/51 and a4 is equal to 17/14. Did you get all the coefficients A1 to A4?
No, I have done till A3. I'll have to do the A3.
Okay. And what about the others? Shabai pecho, everyone? তো কারোর গলায় পাচ্ছি না অরিজিৎ দীপ ডিড ইউ গেট দ্য কোএফিসিয়েন্টস দ্য লাস্ট ওয়ান A4 হোয়াট ইজ A4 সায়ন পেয়েছ তোমরা
সেভেন্টিন বাই ফোরটিন
পেয়েছ
হ্যাঁ ম্যাম
ওকে সো নাও ইউ ক্যান আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড দ্যাট ইফ দ্য হাইয়েস্ট ডিগ্রি ইজ 4 ইউ উইল গেট 4 কোয়েফিসিয়েন্টস And the system to be Hartzweig, the function to be Hartzweig, all these coefficient a1, a2, a3, a4, since here the denominator, since the highest power is 4, you will get 4 coefficients. For higher, more higher degrees, you will get more number of coefficients. Here you can see the coefficients are 1/3, 9 by 7, 49 by 51, and 17 by 14. So you can see that all the coefficients are positive. Right? They are not negative. So if all the coefficients are positive, then we will say that the given structure system is Hartzweig. Okay. And if the system is Hartzweig, then it will be positive real. So the given example, this system corresponds to a positive real function. Clear? And remember that this is the necessary and sufficient condition. Necessary and sufficient. That means if you can perform this continued fraction method and if all the coefficients come out to be positive, you don't need to find out any other procedure. You don't need to carry out any other procedures. Okay. If all the terms are positive after continued fraction, then it will be Hartzweig polynomial if the all the coefficients are positive. Now go to another example where we will study a different thing. Here, what as an example, PS is given. Here you can see that the value of expression of PS is s to the power 5 plus 2 s to the power 4 plus 6 x cube plus 12 s square plus 25 s. Okay. Plus 50, sorry. So first thing will be to separate out the even and odd terms. So even terms RS is equal to 2S to the power 4 plus 12S square plus 50. And the odd terms TS is equal to S to the power 5 plus 6S cube plus 25S. Okay. Here you can see that so after the separation of RS and TS, what you have to do? You have to take the ratio between RS and TS. Okay, so RS by TS means 2S to the power 4 plus 12S square plus 50 divided by S to the power 5 plus 6S cube plus 25S. Here you can see that the numerator has a degree of 4, but the denominator has a degree of 5. So is it possible to do the division or we have to take the inversion first? What is your answer?
Inversion.
Okay. So you can see that first inversion is taken. 1 divided by TS by RS. Right? Now, TS, if you take S common from TS, then you will get it is S to the power 4 plus 6S square plus 25. Right? And if you take 2 common from RS, then you will get S to the power 4 plus 6x square plus 25. So in both RS and TS, there is a common factor. what is the common factor? It is s to the power 4 plus 6s square plus 25. And since there is a common factor, so the answer will be just s by 2. Right? Because from TS, S is common, and from RS, 2 is common. And if you take the division of TS and RS, then the result will be S by 2 plus 0, 5, 0, because there is a common factor, so no residue is left. There is no residue. Right? So RS by TS is equal to first inversion, that means 1, divided by TS RS, which comes out to be S by 2 only. Clear? Up to this clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So, as we seen, as we have seen from the previous example, that if the highest degree is 4, then there should be at least 4 coefficient. Not at least, should be at least 3 coefficient, because A1 can be 0 if the denominator has higher degree. So, there should be at least 3 coefficients for n equal to 4. Similarly, here the highest power is 5, right? S to the power 5. So there should be at least 4 coefficients. But what we have received? We have got only 1 coefficient, which comes out to be half. S by 2 means A1 equal to half. Right? So it is not the complete answer, complete picture. It is not a complete picture. We have to do extra things so that we can find out whether the polynomial, given polynomial, is Hartree's or not. And what is that extra part? Now, the extra part will be you have to find out the roots. Okay, I told you in this example that this is the necessary and sufficient condition. Because here all the coefficients are positive, so you don't need to be worried about the positive real positivity of the function. But since here we can't define all the coefficients to be positive, so we have to now find out the roots. And I told you that the roots should be always real, real but in the left up plane, or can be on the j omega axis. So what is the common factor? Here common factor is s to the power 4 plus 6 s square plus 25. And if you take the fraction of this expression, you will get it is as s square plus 2s plus 5 and s square minus 2s plus 5. Okay. So s square plus 2s plus 5 into s square minus 2s plus 5. So you can write s to the power 4 plus 6 square plus 25 as the product of s square plus 2s plus 5 and s square minus 2s plus 5. Now s square plus 2s plus 5, you can easily find out by Sridhar Acharya rule that what will be the roots. And for s square plus 2s plus 5, the roots will be s plus 1 plus 2j and s plus 1 minus 2j. That means what are the roots? From the first two product terms, what will be the roots? S equal to? S equal to what? Hello? Can you hear me?
Minus 1.
Minus 1?
Plus minus 2i.
2j, right? So 2J. Minus 1 plus minus 1 minus 2j is one root, and minus 1 plus 2j is another root. So minus 1, the real part is minus 1. So it is in the left half of the S plane, right? Not there is no root on the right half plane. And plus minus 2j means they are on the imaginary axis and they are single, not multiple in number. Okay. So since minus 1 means left side of the S plane and plus minus 2j means on the j omega axis, so we can say that the system is Hartree, the system is positive real. But if you see the next two roots, that means for s square minus 2s plus 5, you can see that s equal to 1 plus 2j and 1 minus 2j. Can you see from the next term? You first apply Sridhar Acharya for these two expressions, s square plus 2s plus 5 and square minus 3s plus 5 and tell me whether you have got the same answer or not. Do it, okay? Okay, so since it is 1, 1 means the real part is on the right half plane. It is not minus 1, it is 1, right? S equal to 1 plus minus 2j. So 1 means it is right half of the S plane. So we can say that the system is not Hurwitz. That means the system is not positive real because there are two roots on the right half of the S plane. One is 1 plus 2j and another is 1 minus 2j. So what you can see that the common factor of RS and TS has two roots on the right half plane. Since it is the common factor, so for both cases, this factor is common. So if it has a root on the right half plane, that means the system will have a root on the right half plane. And from the condition of Hurwitz, you see that if the system root is on the right half of the S plane, then the polynomial is not Hurwitz. So though you can see that all the coefficients are positive, but the system is not stable because there are two roots on the right half plane. Clear? Any doubt? Yes, so if any problem you got such a premature termination, since it is premature termination, then you have to remember that you have to find out the roots. Okay, first thing you have to do the continued fraction, that means inversion, division or division inversion depending on the degree of the polynomials. And if it terminates prematurely, that means if you can't get all the coefficients, then you have to find out the roots. And if any roots is in the right half of the S plane, then you can easily say without no doubt that it is not Hurwitz or not positive real function. The system is unstable. Okay?
Roots gulo imaginary hole ar ki unstable hoye jemon kotha.
No, not imaginary. Imaginary axis e thaktei pare. সেটাই তো বললাম প্লাস দেখো ফার্স্ট ফর দ্য ফার্স্ট টু রুটস এস ইকুয়াল টু মাইনাস ওয়ান প্লাস মাইনাস টু জে মাইনাস ওয়ান প্লাস মাইনাস টু জে মাইনাস ওয়ানটা ইম্পর্টেন্ট বিকজ মাইনাস ওয়ান ইজ দ্য রিয়েল পার্ট ইমাজিনারি অ্যাক্সিসে থাকলেও কিছু যায় আসে না ফর দ্য ফার্স্ট টু রুটস তুমি দেখো ফার্স্ট টু রুটস এ মাইনাস ওয়ান ইজ দ্য রিয়েল পার্ট মাইনাস ওয়ান মিনস ইট ইজ ইন দ্য লেফট প্লেন রাইট বাট ফর দ্য নেক্সট টু রুটস ইউ সি দ্য রুটস স্টার্টেড উইথ 1 প্লাস মাইনাস 2j 1 মিন্স আমরা যখন কোনো প্লট করি এক্স ওয়াই অ্যাক্সিসে 0 0 ইজ দ্য অরিজিন মাইনাস 1 মিন্স ইন দ্য লেফট সাইড এন্ড প্লাস 1 মিন্স ইন দ্য রাইট সাইড রাইট হ্যাঁ তো রাইট সাইডে কোনো রুট থাকলেই দ্য সিস্টেম ইজ আনস্টেবল কেন আনস্টেবল দ্যাট উইল ইউজ লার্ন ইন দ্য সিগন্যাল এন্ড সিস্টেম ক্লাস ওকে কেন রাইট সাইডে কোনো রুটস থাকলেই সিস্টেমটা আনস্টেবল হয়ে যাবে কেন দ্যাট ইউ উইল স্টাডি আমি সেটা ডিটেলে পড়াবো না এখানে জাস্ট রিমেম্বার মানে ধরে নাও যে যদি লেফট সাইডে থাকে কোনো রুটস রিয়েল রুটস ওকে ইমাজিনারি রুটস থাকতেই পারে এবং থাকবেও ইমাজিনারি যদি রিয়েল রুটস এর ভ্যালুটা মাইনাস হয় দেন ইট উইল বি স্টেবল এন্ড প্লাস হলে আনস্টেবল আর ইমাজিনারির জন্য যেটা আমি বললাম মাল্টিপল যদি হয় ধরো 2j হোল স্কয়ার আছে প্লাস মাইনাস 2j হোল স্কয়ার প্লাস টু জে একটা রুট মাইনাস টু জে আর একটা রুট কিন্তু প্লাস টু জে হোল স্কোয়ার যখনই আমি বলছি তার মানে টু জে টা অ্যাট ওমেগা ইকুয়াল টু জে ওমেগা ইকুয়াল টু টু জে সেখানে দুটো রুটস আছে মাল্টিপল রুটস যদি আমাদের এরকম আসতো যে এই এই আনসার অঙ্কটাতেই ধরো এই ধরো যে ব্রেক করছে এখন তো আমার ইচ্ছা হচ্ছে না প্রবলেম হচ্ছে
এইবার শোনা যাচ্ছে
ওকে ধরো রুটসটা দে বেরোলো মাইনাস ওয়ান প্লাস মাইনাস টু জে হোল স্কোয়ার বুঝলে তাহলে মাইনাস ওয়ান মানে মিনস ইট ইজ অন দ্য লেফট প্লেন, বাট যেমনি আমি প্লাস মাইনাস টু জে হোল স্কোয়ার করলাম তেমনি কি হলো, প্লাস টু জে তে দুটো রুটস চলে এলো, মাইনাস টু জে তে দুটো রুটস চলে এলো। সো মাল্টিপল রুটস থাকলেও সিস্টেম আবার আনস্টেবল হয়ে যাবে যদি জে ওমেগা অ্যাক্সিস হয়। সো জে ওমেগা অ্যাক্সিসে মানে ইমাজিনারি হলেই যে আনস্টেবল হবে এরকম নয়, ইমাজিনারি হলে অবশ্যই স্টেবল হবে যদি সিঙ্গেল রুট থাকে, কিন্তু আনস্টেবল হবে যদি মাল্টিপল রুট থাকে। চারটে কন্ডিশন সবসময় মনে রাখবে, একটা হচ্ছে রিয়েল পার্ট, একটা ইমাজিনারি পার্ট। রিয়েল পার্ট যদি নেগেটিভ হয় সিস্টেম ইজ স্টেবল, রিয়েল পার্ট যদি পজিটিভ হয় সিস্টেম ইজ আনস্টেবল। আর ফর ইমাজিনারি দুটো জিনিস মনে রাখবে, একটা হচ্ছে সিঙ্গেল ইমাজিনারি রুট, মাল্টিপল ইমাজিনারি রুট। সিঙ্গেল ইমাজিনারি রুট যদি হয় মানে একটাই রুট আছে প্লাস প্লাস জে মাইনাস জেতে, তাহলে সেটা স্টেবল সিস্টেম। আর প্লাস জে মাইনাস জেতে যদি দুটো বা তিনটে বা মোর দেন দোজ থাকে তাহলে সেক্ষেত্রে আনস্টেবল। সো দুটোরই পজিটিভ নেগেটিভ ব্যাপার আছে, একটা নেগেটিভ রিয়েলের জন্য নেগেটিভ হলে স্টেবল, পজিটিভ হলে আনস্টেবল, আর ইমাজিনারির জন্য সিঙ্গেল রুট হলে স্টেবল, মাল্টিপল রুট হলে আনস্টেবল। এই চারটে পয়েন্ট মনে থাকবে, বোঝা গেছে?
হ্যাঁ ম্যাম।
ওকে, সো লেটস কাম টু দ্য নেক্সট প্রবলেম। হেয়ার অ্যানাদার এক্সাম্পল ইজ গিভেন, হেয়ার অলরেডি দ্য সেপারেশন বিটুইন আর এস অ্যান্ড টি এস হ্যাজ ডান। So what is the function PS? It is s to the power 5 plus s to the power 4 plus 5 s cube plus 2 s square plus 4 s plus 2, right? So, since you can see that the denominator has higher degree than numerator, so the first step will be inversion. Do by yourself. Okay, first take the inversion and then division, again inversion and division. In this way ওয়ান বাই এস এসেছে। ওকে, দেন টেক দ্য ইনভার্সন, দ্যাট মিন্স ওয়ান বাই দ্য রেস্ট রেসিডিউ প্লাস ডিনোমিনেটর, রেসিডিউ বাই ডিনোমিনেটর। ইন দিস ওয়ে কন্টিনিউ, সিন্স ইট ইজ ফাইভ ডিগ্রি সো ইউ শুড গেট অ্যাট লিস্ট ফোর কোএফিসিয়েন্টস। নেক্সট এস বাই টু এসেছে। ওকে, দেন এগেন টেক দ্য ইনভার্সন অ্যান্ড ইউ উইল সি দ্যাট ব্যাগে থাকতে পারে, ক্লাস হচ্ছে। তুমি একটু সন্তুলাকে জিজ্ঞাসা করো। Did you get the whole term? Yes, it is 2s by 2 and the common factor is again s square plus 1, right? So yes, you have got three coefficients, but here again you got a common factor of s square plus 1, right? From the denominator and numerator?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, since it is the degree is 5 and you got only three coefficients, so it is premature termination, right? You have to get at least four coefficients, but you receive you got only three coefficients, a1 equal to 1, a2 equal to half and a3 equal to 1, right?
Yes,
So what will be our next job? Next job is to find out the root of the common factor. And what is the common factor here? Yes. So what will be the root? A square plus 1 is the common factor, and you know the root
plus, minus,
plus j. Minus j, right? And you can see plus minus j means it is on the j omega axis. 1 is above 0, 1 axis, 0, 0 origin, another is below 0, 0, 0 axis, but on the imaginary axis. And I told you, if the imaginary root is single, not multiple in nature, then you can say that the system is stable, because all the rest coefficients, that means a1, a2, a3 are positive, a1 equal to 1, a2 equal to half, and a3 equal to 1. And at the same time, you got two single imaginary roots. Right? So is the system stable or not? It is Hartree or not? What is your answer?
Stable, ma'am.
So it is Hartree, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Because the coefficients are positive, at the same time the roots are either real, the real part of the roots are either real or even imaginary, but not on the positive half plane. Right? Okay. And another information, that if here in this case, what you have, what we have done, all the coefficients, all the terms are present. That means odd terms, even terms, all terms are present, right? But if you have given a function where it contains only either even terms or odd terms, then what you have to do? You have to take the summation of PS and QS to find out whether it is Hartree or not. Suppose PS is S square plus 5. That means it is even power of S. And QS is S cube plus 5S. So it is even power, odd power in S. So to, if there is only even power or odd power, then you can't take the division RS by TS, because RS will be, only RS will be there or TS will be there. Right? So to get the ratio of RS and TS, what you have to do? You have to take the summation of PS and QS. That means summation of numerator and denominator. And then you will test for the Hartree. Bujha gache?
Arekta bolun na?
Okay, darao. Ami next page chole gechi. আমি একটা এক্সাম্পল দিয়ে বলি, ওকে? সাপোজ তোমরা লেখো, খাতায় লেখো, তাহলে বুঝতে পারবে কি বলতে চাইছি। সাপোজ পিএস, দ্যাট মিন্স দ্য ফাংশন দ্যাট টেস্ট ওয়েদার ইট ইজ হার্টবিট অর নট, পিএস ইজ গিভেন অ্যাজ এস স্কোয়ার প্লাস 2, ওকে, অ্যান্ড কিউএস ইজ গিভেন অ্যাজ S cube plus 5S. Okay, and you have to test whether FS means PS by QS is Hartree or not. Likhecho proshnota?
What is
QS, ma'am?
PS equal to S square plus 2 and QS is equal to S cube plus 5S. Likhecho? You have to find out.
Another question, take me repeat korben, ma'am.
হ্যাঁ বলছি তো, বলছি তো, শুনতে পাচ্ছ?
হ্যাঁ ম্যাম।
পিএস ইকুয়াল টু, আমি তোমাদের বোঝার জন্য বলছি, একটা এক্সাম্পল লেখো, পিএস ইকুয়াল টু এস স্কোয়ার প্লাস 2, দ্যাট মিন্স পিএস ইজ এ ইভেন ফাংশন, অ্যান্ড লেখো কিউএস ইকুয়াল টু এস কিউ প্লাস 5S, দ্যাট মিন্স কিউএস ইজ অ্যান অড ফাংশন, রাইট? নেক্সট লাইনে লেখো FS, ক্যাপিটাল FS, ক্যাপিটাল এফ ফাংশন অফ এস ব্র্যাকেটের মধ্যে ইজ ইকুয়াল টু পিএস বাই কিউএস, যেটা আমি ফার্স্ট লাইনে লিখেছিলাম, ফার্স্ট, একদম ফার্স্টে লিখেছিলাম। সো ইন দ্যাট কেস, ইফ আই টোল্ড ইউ টু ফাইন্ড আউট দ্যাট ওয়েদার এফ এস ইজ হার্টজিজ অর নট, তোমরা কি করতে পারবে?
will you able to do? Whether it is Harjeet or not, parbena, because numerator contains only even terms and denominator contains only odd terms, right? So jodi shudhu even terms e thake, ami even or odd terms e separate out korbo kibhabe? And if I am not able to separate out the even or odd terms, ami tahole division nebo ki kore? Division of RS and TS hobe kibhabe? যখনই আমাদের কোনো ফাংশন দেওয়া থাকছিল এই এক্সাম্পলগুলোতে দেখো আমরা ফার্স্ট কি করছিলাম ফার্স্ট উই সেপারেট আউট দ্য ইভেন টার্মস অ্যান্ড অড টার্মস দেন উই টেক দ্য ডিভিশন বিটুইন ইভেন টার্মস অ্যান্ড অড টার্মস এখানে আমার শুধু ইভেন টার্মসই আছে পিএস এ অ্যান্ড কিউএস এ অনলি অড টার্মস আছে তাহলে আমি পিএস কে কি আর এস আর টিএস এ ভাঙতে পারবো অথবা কিউএস কে কি আর এস অ্যান্ড টিএস এ ভাঙতে পারবো
না না
যদি আমি ভাঙতে না পারি আমার কাছে আইদার আর এস আছে অর টিএস আছে পিএস এর জন্য অনলি আর এস পেয়েছি আর কিউএস এর জন্য অনলি টিএস পেয়েছি তাহলে তো আমি ডিভিশন করতে পারবো না
হ্যাঁ
সেক্ষেত্রে আমাকে কি করতে হবে ইউ হ্যাভ টু অ্যাড পিএস অ্যান্ড কিউএস ইফ ইউ অ্যাড পিএস অ্যান্ড কিউএস তাহলে দেখো ইভেন অড সব টার্মই পেয়ে গেছো নাও ইউ ক্যান টেক দ্য ডিভিশন বোঝা গেছে মানে বেসিক্যালি আমরা পিএস প্লাস কিউএস ফাংশনটা হার্জিজ কিনা দেখব আমরা শুধু পিএস দেখতে পাচ্ছি না কারণ পিএস এ পিএস এ কোনো অড টার্মস নেই শুধু কিউএস ও দেখতে পাচ্ছি না কারণ কিউএস এ কোনো ইভেন টার্মস নেই সেই জন্য আমরা পিএস প্লাস কিউএস টার্মটা দেখব সেটা হার্জিজ কিনা ক্লিয়ার ওকে তো এটা তোমরা করো আমি নেক্সট ক্লাসটা এটা করবে বাড়িতে এবং বলবে আমাকে সিস্টেমটা হার্জিজ এলো কিনা ওকে আমি জানি না কিন্তু আমি এটা নিজে নিজেই দিয়েছি আমি জানি না সিস্টেমটাতে তোমার কোএফিসিয়েন্টস গুলো নেগেটিভ আসবে না পজিটিভ আসবে করে আমাকে নেক্সট ক্লাসে বলবে আর এটা থেকে আমি নেক্সট ক্লাসটা নেব ওকে
ওকে
ঠিক আছে থ্যাংক ইউ
ওকে